today, ladies and gentlemen, marks the milestone of 5 years of collaboration in climate change and health, and that is the launch of its first action plan, a plan that was developed to ensure that we are able to protect the health and well-being of our communities and workforce from the impacts of climate change. At the highest level of government, commitment to climate change adaptation and mitigation is at national, global, and regional levels. National, regional, and global levels. Fiji is among the vulnerable island nations that are facing severe effects of climate change. Our coastal communities are experiencing rising sea levels, exacerbated by more devastating disasters such as cyclones, floods, and drought. Our facilities and infrastructure experience greater damage with the increasing intensities and frequencies of natural disasters. Food security is threatened as planting areas get inundated with seawater and oceans become increasingly acidified. Access to safe water supply is compromised due to the severe drought, saltwater intrusion, and frequent flooding, contaminating domestic water supplies. So basically, human survival is at risk. Life itself is under threat in Fiji for our people from the impact of this climate change. Ladies and gentlemen, we must take action. We must continue the fight against the forces that have led to climate change in the first place. We must also learn and adapt to what has already happened and prepare for future events. Communicable diseases spread by mosquitoes have increased. Current trends show increasing frequencies of diseases such as dengue, diarrhea, typhoid outbreaks. The recent emergence of new diseases such as chikungunya and Zika in the recent past is also attributed to changing climate. Climate change and natural disasters also have an indirect impact on NCDs, as our people are forced to resort to processed foods to survive. Increasing temperatures and extreme weather discourages our people from outdoor activities, leading to sedentary lifestyles which promote NCDs. In different environments, certain factors that may increase human health vulnerability to extreme weather and climate events, and this includes age, older adults and younger children, chronic medical conditions, low levels of physical fitness or physical mobility, physical or mental impairment, social isolation and poverty. The Ministry's initial encounter with climate change was in 2010, when Fiji became one of the 7 project countries for global environment facilities, piloting climate change adaptation to protect human health. This project was jointly implemented by World Health Organization and Ministry of Health and Medical Services. This program, as mentioned, PSEF, projected 3 main outcomes, namely 1, develop a climate-based disease early warning system in project pilot sites, 2, institutional strengthening data reporting and disease response, and 3, piloting health adaptation activities in pilot site communities. This project was completed in 2015 and highlighted the following issues. 1, the need to increase the priority of addressing climate change and health risk in national plans, and to ensure climate change is effectively mainstreamed into national health policies and plans. Furthermore, the Ministry of Health and Medical Services would like to ensure that global, regional, and national commitments are captured in activities to address climate change and health. The Climate Change and Health Strategic Action Plan is a strategic approach to promote the health agenda in these commitments made by our leaders in global, regional, and national forums. Examples of commitments that have been used to develop the plan include United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, COP21 Paris Agreement, the World Health Assembly resolutions since 2008, 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, the 2015 Suva Declaration, the 2015 Yanuda Island Declaration of Pacific Health Ministers Meeting, the Green Growth Framework of 2014, and the National Climate Change Policy of 2012. The plan's mission is to build resilience to climate change impacts on health by empowering and assisting our people through an adaptive and sustainable health system in Fiji. The goal of the plan is to implement measures in adaptation to climate change for the health system in order to prevent and reduce current and future risks to our people's health and well-being. It also supports the application of the Health Emergency and Disaster Management Action Plan, ensuring sustainable developments within and outside Ministry of Health and Medical Services. The plan is based on the World Health Organization's operational framework for building climate-resilient health systems and provide guidance for health systems and public health programming to increase human capacity for protecting health in an unstable and changing climate. The action areas of adaptations are incorporated under the 10 components that are developed from the WHO framework. The first component of the plan includes the establishment and building capacity of a climate change and health unit within our ministry to strengthen its partnership and cooperation. Component two is about a well-trained health workforce knowledgeable in climate change and health. Components three, four, and five address improvements to the health system in general, with particular focus on using existing data or through profiling to identify communities most vulnerable to climate variability and change and associated health exposures. The sixth component provides an essential preventative and curative health products, example vaccines, and planning climate resilient infrastructure. Components 7, 8, and 9 emphasize management of environmental determinants of health, consideration of climate risks and vulnerability in health programming, and operations using emergency and disaster risk management policies for enhanced preparedness for health system. And the final component of climate and health financing will involve mobilizing resources for appropriate climate change and health adaptation programs to address health risks presented by climate change. I therefore urge everyone with a vested interest in health and in climate change to assist in the implementing the 2016 and 2020 plan. Implementation of the strategic action plan, of course, will need resources and would encourage regional cooperation and intergovernmental support. The plan, properly implemented, will empower the health system to address climate change and health issues and protect our public health in Fiji. Ladies and gentlemen, climate change impacts on health is well established through research and available data. Thus, the significance of ensuring the completion and implementation of the plan should remain our obligation as stakeholders and personnel of the health sector, and more importantly, as precious occupiers of this world. The World Health Organization has been our partner in the development of this plan and an advocate for climate change and health in Fiji. At this point, please allow me to acknowledge the tremendous support, both technical and financial, that has been provided by WHO. Support and collaboration by Climate Change Division of the Ministry of Economy is also acknowledged. Please allow me to conclude by saying that I look forward to all our development partners and collaborating agencies for their support in achieving the goal of this plan in the next 5 years, and direct the climate change and health and disaster risk reduction team effective implementation of this plan. These words, thank you very much, and have a nice day.